Hi, my name is Amit Moryosef, and I'll be presenting real-time sign language detection using human pose estimation. This work is a collaboration between Google and the University of Zurich. We believe that video conferencing applications should be accessible to everyone. However, because current apps only detect speakers by voice activation, it is hard to see who is signing at any given moment, or for signers to get the floor themselves. Recently, Borg and Camilleri introduced sign language detection as the classification of every video frame into either signing or not signing. As they aim for offline video processing, they use a context window around a given frame and feed it into large models not suitable for real-time applications, taking over 3 seconds per inference. In this work, we design a real-time sign language detection model using human pose estimation and build an app that detects when a user is signing, setting them as the speaker in all video conferencing applications. We use the German Sign Language Corpus, which includes long videos of people signing, comes pre-processed with OpenPose pose estimation, and includes span annotation to whether a person is signing or not in any given frame. This dataset also includes distractors and negative examples where people move without signing. Using this corpus, we train a sequence tagging model in the following way. We first extract human poses from the video frames. Then, we calculate the optical flow by finding the distance each landmark moves in every 2 consecutive frames. We feed this optical flow into a unidirectional LSTM and classify each state as either signing or not signing. Around our model, we built an app running in real time in the browser. We start by using PoseNet human pose estimation with TensorFlow.js. For speed, we decided to only use the body landmarks, which are much faster to acquire and only result in 1% accuracy drop compared to all landmarks. Then, we calculate an optical flow vector from which it predicts whether the user is currently signing or not using our model. If the participant is predicted to be signing, we transmit inaudible audio through the participant's microphone. This audio is then caught by any video conferencing app, which thinks the signing user is now speaking. Now, let's look at an example of what it's like for a signer to use our app. Meet Mayan. Mayan is an Israeli sign language interpreter. As you start signing, we can see the signing meter goes to 100 and the speaking indicator is spinning. When she stops signing, we can see the signing meter goes down and the speaker indicator stops spinning. This signal is then transmitted to all video conferencing applications and is treated as if she used her voice to speak. Let me conclude by reiterating that we believe video conferencing applications should be accessible to everyone. We hope this work makes a step in this direction and that our app can empower signers to use whichever video conferencing application they would like in a more convenient way. Future work may include using a better and faster pose estimation system, designing a more accurate sign language detector, adding mobile phone support, and maybe even aim for real-time sign language translation. Thanks for watching!